I think that the Republican nomination will come down to Scott Walker versus Jeb Bush. I think on the Democratic side, it's Hillary Clinton's for the asking, and I believe, if you're asking me to go out on a limb, that she would beat any Republican candidate in an open election next year.
Okay, and her vice president, do you think, would be?
That's a more interesting question. I think she would have the potential to go off the board, perhaps choose a military officer.
Who would be?
There are several who are Democrats. She might pick a high-tech executive, or she might pick somebody who's currently serving in the Senate or the governorship who they want to groom as a potential presidential candidate down the line.
You have the, with the name? Do you have any names on that?
Unfortunately, we're out of time.
Oh, we're getting out of time. And there's always, you know, Condoleezza Rice and, you know.
On the Republican side
that people don't mention because she has some real strong, you know, she's a very strong, and especially on international politics, while we still have the time, you could talk real fast.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised to see either party choose a vice presidential candidate who comes from a business background. Because the economy, in every public opinion poll that has come out in the last 6 months, the economy is the number one issue that voters are looking at. And choosing somebody who was the head of a large business concern would be a very likely choice. High-tech companies tend to support the Democrats. Traditional manufacturing tend to support the Republicans. I think that both parties would have some really interesting folks to choose from. Carly Fiorina, on the Republican side, might end up as a vice presidential candidate, depending on who the presidential candidate is.
You know, it's so funny, and as I see the credits coming down, I want to invite you, Barry, back, because we're, you know, as we get closer, you know, things are going to be changing.
Yes.
And so we may have a completely different program than in 6 months from now. So I really wish you'd come back, because I know the viewers love you. I know our camera people and our people behind the scenes here really enjoy you, and I'm so happy that you finally got on Cahnmann's Roundtable.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure to be here.
And it's been really good seeing you and hearing what you have to say, because I think it's really important that people, you know, see things from a different aspect. You know, a lot of our shows, you know, tell you one thing, and on Cahnmann's Roundtable, we'll hear the opposite of everything that happens. Cahnmann's Roundtable is brought to you by Barry Bradford, Cahnmann
handle services and all of the high holidays, and there was a remarkable number of Jewish recruits down there too. And during the Passover time, a dear friend of mine, Dave Smiles, a World War II vet who had been called back to duty, I don't know his rank, could have been major.
Yeah, I think he was a major. We have a picture up now.
There it is. There's a picture.
There's the picture.
Of,
uh,